Later in this episode... But first...
Hey everybody, it's Molly with All Ears, and I'm here today with a brand new video. Happy holidays, Merry Christmas. It's early November, but it's already Christmas time across Walt Disney World. So I am headed to the Disney parks today to eat and drink as many holiday treats as I can to find out which one is the merriest, which one's the jolliest, and which one maybe should be left to the Grinch. I hope you're ready. I hope you're excited. I hope you're hungry. Let's get to it. First stop at Magic Kingdom, the Main Street Bakery, because one, Starbucks has released all their holiday drinks, so like an eggnog latte, peppermint hot chocolate, chestnut praline latte. That's all for you. Take your pick. I still like pumpkin more, but I can get down with the eggnog. I'm also grabbing this Twice Upon a Cupcake. It's a confetti Christmas tree cupcake with a red velvet hidden Mickey inside of it. Will it look this good when I actually cut it open? Only a few moments will tell. Okay, here's my cupcake. Look how cute it is. Look at it, friends. Oh my gosh, it's so cute. There really is a red velvet Mickey in there. Oh my gosh. But does it taste good? Let's find out. Yes. Well, I just got cake. I'm gonna get icing. There's funfetti cake to hold the tree up, so it's actually less frosting than it looks like, which I appreciate. Because I'm more about the cake than the frosting. And we've got these little sugar ornaments. That's straight sugar. But the cake itself with the red velvet is very good. And I don't know if there's ever been a more Instagrammable treat than the one that has a hidden Mickey inside of it. Disney cupcakes don't always do it for me, but this one is a winner in my book. Simple flavors, adorable design, and deceivingly less frosting than you thought. I'm gonna wash it down with this chestnut praline latte. Never had it. Oh, but into it. It's not very sweet. She said it would taste like Cheerios, and it kind of does, which is weird, but it's got a little hint of sweetness on the back end, but it really does have like a wheat taste. I don't know. If you're not into eggnog or something super sweet, try this one out. It's very good. On a scale of 1 to 10 for this cupcake, where 1 is when Snape cheats on Trelawney. Horrible in Love Actually. And a 10 is when Colin Farrell Firth learns Portuguese and the girl learns English so they can get engaged. Beautiful moment, Love Actually. Cry every time. I am going to award this an All I Want for Christmas Is You finale at the show, which is about an 8.5. Very good cupcake, very Instagrammable. Hi, can I get the sugar and spice churros, please? These are the sugar and spice holiday churros. They are described as Christmas cookie churros with icing and holiday sprinkles and then eggnog. And I thought that meant an eggnog dipping sauce, but no, they literally mean a cup of eggnog. I love eggnog, so I'm here for this. Churro time. Also, I'm sitting in the hub grass. It is so lovely and it's relaxing. I gotta say, it just tastes like a churro. Maybe a little less cinnamony, but it doesn't taste like a Christmas cookie. Eggnog, my first sip of this holiday season, 2020. So these are very cute, but they're not that exciting. Except for the eggnog, maybe I'll dip it in the eggnog. That does things. On a scale of 1 to 10, where 1 is when Buddy the Elf learns his dad is on the naughty list, and a 10 is when he runs and he jumps on the Christmas tree, because that's my absolute favorite part of that whole movie, that would be a 10. I'm gonna give this a Buddy the Elf making breakfast of Pop-Tarts and spaghetti and everything he could find in the kitchen, which is about a 6.5, 7, because they're good if you like churros. It tastes like a good churro, but it's not that exciting. So I'm looking for a little more pump, a little more uniqueness in my holiday treats. Mobile ordered myself the brand new holiday float from Aloha Isle and Adventureland. It's a pistachio chai tea float. So that's pistachio flavored soft serve and then chai tea soft serve. And then it's got a red velvet cake pop. So this thing sounds crazy town. Here we go. I'm a little scared. Pistachio's not bad. It's aggressively pistachio though, which I like. But if you don't like it, you will not like this. I'm gonna try and get some of the chai tea, which is kind of down at the bottom. Huh. I don't know how I feel about them together. Who made this up? Who decided these were the two flavors that need to go together? It's definitely another, this is gonna be the one that some people hate and some people love, but I'm leaning more towards love. I am mad that we replaced the coconut. They got rid of the coconut for this, and that kind of makes me furious because the coconut's the best. Hmm. It's a very good, very chewy red velvet cake pop. Again, that flavor doesn't go with these flavors, so this is definitely the weirdest dessert you're gonna have. On a scale of 1 to 10, where 1 is the ghost of Christmas past in the Muppets Christmas Carol, because she scares me a lot, and a 10 is when little Kermit's baby says, God bless us everyone, at the end of Muppet Christmas Carol, I'm gonna award this an Ebenezer Scrooge song, because it's about a bad guy, so you shouldn't like it, but you do. And that's kind of how I feel about this. So I'm gonna give this one like a 7.5, because I don't love it, but I don't hate it, and I give props for its originality. This is the one I want more of you to eat, and let me know what you think. Look at this little cutie patootie. It's called an Orange Bird Christmas. You can get it at Sunshine Tree Terrace, and it's in white chocolate mousse with orange in it, and then it's got a little orange like cookie thing on it, and then a little orange bird and Santa hat on top. This is the best thing I could do to show you the inside. It's again white chocolate mousse, and then it's got literal little chunks of oranges in there, and it's an orange zest. Now, to be fair, I love both chocolate and orange. So for me, this is excellent. It's unusual, it's adorable, so Instagrammable. And I love the orange chocolate. It tastes like one of those things. Have you ever had those things where you like it's a chocolate orange and then you smack it and then it like slices? That's what it tastes like to me. It's really good. And it's definitely not like anything else you're gonna get. And it's super flavorful, but it's not super rich because it's light because of the mousse consistency and also the orange. So yeah, this one's a winner again this year in my book. On a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being when Mayor Augustus Mayhew is a little child and he makes fun of the Grinch. It's not nice. And the 10 being when the Grinch, his heart grows 3 sizes that day and he saves Cindy Lou Who. I will award this that time when the Grinch saves Cindy Lou Who because it's unexpected yet hilarious and kind of adorable. And that's what this dessert is. So that's about an 8.5. The next treat is from Pecos Bills. I forget it every time. Tall Tale Inn and Cafe. It is a Let It Snow taco, and it's a sugar cookie taco shell. And then inside you've got a salted caramel and a spiced chocolate mousse. So this one's getting big points for creativity, but how's it gonna taste? No way to do it gracefully, so you just gotta do it. I want the chocolate to be stronger. The chocolate mousse is a little muted. Let's try the caramel mousse. The caramel mousse is better. Now just a cookie. And I love sugar cookies. Like Christmas sugar cookies are my jam. But it's kind of mediocre. I'm really sad because I don't love this one. And it's so cute. I would love to love it. And it's so unique. But it all falls flat a little bit. It's kind of a bummer. I don't like not liking things, but I'm always honest with you guys so you know what's the good stuff. On a scale of 1 to 10, where 1 is when John McClane's wife isn't very nice to him, and 10 is yippee-ki-yay, I'm gonna give this one he has to walk on the glass with his bare feet because it looked cool, but it wasn't great, and that's about a 5. And yes, I do believe Die Hard's a Christmas movie. Discuss in the comments if you disagree. This is my next treat right here. These are from Westward Ho. These are Chippendale's Christmas churros. It's a gingerbread flavored churro, allegedly. We'll see. And then it's got apple pie filling, chocolate chips, and marshmallow fluff on top. So it definitely sounds like Chippendale were goofing off in the kitchen and made a crazy concoction. This churro, greater than the other churro. I should say flavor-wise. The churro itself, this one's more stale than the other one. That just tastes like a normal churro to me, but it could be gingerbread flavor. I love the apple pie on it, though. That's why I'm enjoying this one. So I like the apple pie filling and the chocolate chips. I wish the churro was fresher, honestly. On a scale of 1 to 10, where 1 is when Charlie gets taken away from Scott Calvin in the Santa Claus, and 10 is when everyone believes in Santa Claus again and he gives them their presents, I'm going to give this a moment when they go to Denny's and they're like, do you want chocolate milk? And he's like, the waitress like, we're out. And he's like, plain milk's fine. And then Scott Calvin goes, at least we know they got hot apple pie. And the waitress goes, we did. He goes, mm-hmm. Because like, it's apple pie and also kind of disappointing. But like, the apple pie part's good at this. So that is about a 7. Just picked this baby up from Pinocchio's Village. Haas mobile ordered it. It's called the Yuletide Wishes, and it kind of looks like a Yule log, but it's just chocolate cake with chocolate mousse inside of it. So it seems like it's gonna be simple, but hopefully delicious. Mm. Wow, that is chocolatey. Oh my goodness. That is so rich. Mm, it's good though. If you love chocolate, if you've been watching this video and you're like, why are you eating pumpkin flavor things? Why are you eating apple? Where's the chocolate? This is it. It is so rich and so delicious, but it's very, because it's so rich, definitely shareable in my opinion. Unless you're like a crazy chocoholic. I just discovered that the top thing is actually a marshmallow. It's like covered in chocolate. So really this is a chocolate lover's treat. On a scale of 1 to 10, with a 1 being when the Grinch tells Cindy Lou Who to go back to bed and pats her head. We're talking animated Grinch now. That's a 1. And a 10 is when the Grinch realizes that being rich and the true meaning of Christmas is actually being surrounded with people and not things. It's a 10. I would give this one a max with the antlers on it, which is about an 8 because it's very, very good. It's simple. It's just really rich. So I'm gonna give it an 8 for flavor-wise. It's not that unique, but it's good flavor-wise.
Hi! I would like one of the Christmas sundaes, please.
She's a little melted, but the next thing on our list is the Minnie's Merry Cherry Sundae. So this is at Storybook Treats in Fantasyland, and it's cherry and vanilla soft serve ice cream, and then a Minnie Mouse bow as a garnish, and some whipped cream chocolate, and some holiday sprinkles. So this is what replaced the Poor Unfortunate Souls float from Halloween, and I gotta say, it's much cuter. I kind of love, oh no. Do I hate this or love this? Initially I was like, oh, soft serve, vanilla soft serve, a little hot fudge, a little sprinkle. And then I got the cherry and I was like, does that taste like medicine? It does a little bit because it's artificial cherry flavor. Now to confirm, it's not cherry Dole Whip, it's cherry soft serve. So this is not plant-based like Dole Whip is. Yeah, the cherry's a little medicinal. But when you get it all together, it's not too bad. In fact, the cherry kind of has a tartness that balances the richness of the vanilla and the chocolate. When you get that cherry alone, it's got a little bit of like, oh, is this Dime Tap? That's great, but you get it. As I continue to eat it though, I have decided I like it. Because I like hot fudge, I like vanilla ice cream. I do not think I'd like to just eat the cherry though. But with it all together, it's good. On a scale of 1 to 10, a 1 being when Vince Vaughn and Reese Witherspoon get in a fight in Four Christmases, and a 10 being when they get back together at the end and they have a baby, I would give this a them fighting with their families while they're playing Taboo, I think it's the game, because it's uncomfortable, but you kind of like it, which is how I feel about this. And I think that's around a 7. This is a new item this year. Super excited. Look how cute this is. This is called the Bell's Enchanted Christmas Tree. It's at Gaston's Tavern, and it's an almond macaroon tree with cranberry orange filling. But I cannot get over how cute this little guy is. I really don't know how to eat this either, so I'm just going to pick up the first layer of the tree. Well, that is scrumptious. The macaron, well, most I tasted the M&M, that was like the decor on the top, so. Okay, that's where the cranberry orange is. It's like in the red layers. And then the macarons themselves are the almond. Yes, I forgot a fork, so I'm just eating with a knife. This one is really good. Like, I've had a lot of treats already, and I'm about to gobble this whole thing up in a record time. Obviously, we're using Bell's Enchanted Christmas for this one. So a number 1 is that scary organ, because that terrified me as a child. Anyone else? And a number 10 would be when they all sing As Long As There's Christmas, which is really nice and heartwarming. And this would be a Bell's Christmas dress, which I gotta say, that's a 10. This is a really awesome treat. It's not overwhelming in any flavor, but it's really unique. It's really, really cute, and it's different, and I'm really into it. Thank you, Gaston's Tavern, because this is a delight. Apparently, Disney just wanted me to eat a bunch of churros today, so I have bought yet another holiday churro. This is from the cart in Storybook Circus. They're called Churros Worth Melting For. And as you can see, they've got a little marshmallow fluff and sprinkles, and then you've got marshmallow fluff to dip it in, but I think this is supposed to be like Olaf melted, because that's his nose, which is pretty dark. Look at that. That's definitely Olaf. I don't know if I want to eat this. It's time to eat Olaf. This feels weird. Olaf tastes pretty good. That's a better churro than the one I had in Frontierland. Like, the churro itself has maintained some of the softness, so it's got the crunchy outside and the softness inside, and it doesn't taste stale. So churro-wise, very good. Marshmallow fluff is delicious. It's a good topping for a churro, so I'm into it. Not into the idea that I'm eating Olaf, though. That's what they mean, right? I mean, it's called a churro worth melting for, and it has a carrot nose, so. I can't remember any bad parts of Frozen, the Christmas special, because it's just delightful. So I'm gonna do Frozen 2. On a scale of 1 to 10, 1 when Olaf dies, because that's what this is, and 10, Show Yourself, because that's a really good song. I'm going to award these churros a Lost in the Woods, because that song's really, really good, and I really enjoyed that part, but I feel like these churros are a little lost, because they're delicious, but what kind of message are they sending? So I'm going to give them a 7.5, because I like them as much as, if not more, some of the other churros I've had, but there's still nothing like crazy over the top that I think is a must-eat, and also the Olaf eating thing. This is the Just a Dream Away milkshake. Does anyone know what that's themed after? Here's a hint. The Carousel of Progress. Isn't that cool? But it also had a Christmas picture on it, so I guess it's a Christmas treat. I don't know. It's a salted caramel milkshake with a churro in it and pretty sprinkles, and it's from Anti-Gravity's Galactic Goodies. I just pulled this out of the milkshake. It's literally a full churro that they bent and shoved into that salted caramel milkshake. Let's start with the churro, because I haven't eaten one for 30 seconds and forgot what it tasted like. I don't know if sticking a churro in a milkshake is a good idea, because it makes it chewy. Let's try the milkshake now. Ooh, I like that salted caramel milkshake. Also, look at the inside of my mask. This is a new mask. It was clean. Anyone else have this issue? Anyway. I have like mask loads of laundry now. It's like lights, darks, masks. Okay. The shake is excellent. I like the salted caramel flavor. Really, really yummy. I could do without the churro, probably because I've had 87 today. But overall, that's a really fun treat, and I'm obsessed with the fact that it's themed after the Carousel of Progress. That is awesome. Obviously, this ranking has to be based on the Christmas scene from Carousel of Progress. So on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being when Dad burns the turkey and 10 being when Uncle Orville says, no privacy at all around this place. I'm going to give this crazy milkshake a gram up, becoming a real flying ace, which is a 9, because it's actually a very good milkshake. If you hadn't eaten 28 churros today, you probably would be excited to have a churro in your thing, and it's themed after the Carousel of Progress. So that's major points. This is the Spice Up Your Holiday Chicken Sandwich. It's a spicy chicken breast with a sriracha aioli and a pickle slaw on a Mickey bun, served with French fries from Cosmic Rays, and I'm excited to just have something that's not sugar, honestly. It honestly tastes like a Chick-fil-A spicy chicken sandwich, because the pickle slaw is like the pickles, and then it's the spicy chicken and it's got the sriracha. That's a good sandwich. It's definitely got a little heat too. Was Sunny Eclipse in the kitchen making this? Maybe. He did a really good job. And Cosmic Rays French fries are always really good. I'm pretty impressed. Cosmic Rays usually does a seasonal sandwich of some kind. This is one of my favorite ones I can remember. Better than Halloween's, better than last year's Christmas. On a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being when Clark Griswold tries to light up the house but can't light up the house, and then 10 being when he tries to light up the house and he does light up the house, I'm giving this a Todd and Margo falling down the stairs, because it's about a 9.5. My only complaint, I wish the chicken patty was bigger, but other than that, it's a very good sandwich and very good fries. Look how beautiful the castle is right now, and also look at the most amazing popcorn bucket they have this year. Last year they had a green version, and some carts still have the green version, but I got this one by the Hub. I love it, the little popcorn strings and Mickey and Minnie. It's so cute! Yeah, Mr. Incredible! I'm in Hollywood Studios to check out their Christmas treats and decorations, because like they put a Santa hat on Gertie, which is very cute. First up, my bounty from the Trolley Car Cafe, which is the bakery. They've got a couple different things. They've got a red velvet whoopie pie. This is currently replacing that famous carrot cake cookie. And then they have the return of this pine cone thing that they had last year. Trolley Car Cafe loves to do these like mousse desserts, and then it's got like a crisped rice shell thing down at the bottom, and it refers to it as a chestnut pine cone. And then I also got a coffee. It's the Thanksgiving blend coffee, and I got a pump of peppermint in there. And look at how they decorated the cup. Oh my gosh, what a great day. Okay, I'm excited to try all of these things. I'll try the pine cone first. Good again. I mean, it's chocolate mousse. I'm gonna get a little of that crispy. Last year, I think it had more of a chestnut flavor, because I remember being like, what's a chestnut? What is a chestnut? What does it taste like? I only know you're supposed to roast them over an open fire. And this year, it's like straight chocolate. But it's still very good, very rich, very cute. So always kind of a fun one. And then I'm gonna try this whoopie pie. I'm just gonna shove it in my face, if I'm being honest. That is so sweet. Wow. It's got the same cream cheese frosting, but now it's red velvet on the outsides. And it's not really, it's more like a whoopie pie. They call the other one a cookie cake, a cookie. But it's a whoopie pie, and it's massive, so definitely a shareable one. Festive blend. And this is the first peppermint thing I've had, and it was peppermint in my coffee. I'm surprised I haven't had like 50 peppermint treats yet. All three very good. I think, excluding the coffee, because obviously the coffee's my favorite, I think I like the whoopie pie a little bit more. That's what I think. On a scale of 1 to 10, where 1 is the Alvin and the Chipmunks Christmas album, because that album was the soundtrack in Dinoland USA when I did a college program there, and I listened to it every single day and for like 2 months during Christmas. And let's say All I Want for Christmas is My Two Front Teeth. Not a great song to hear on repeat. That's one. 10 is All I Want for Christmas is You by Queen Mariah Carey. She's literally on my shirt because that's my favorite Christmas song. I give the Whoopie Pie a Santa Claus is Coming to Town by the Jackson 5, which is a 9. And I give the Pine Cone a Jingle Bells, which is an 8. Next Christmas treat haul is here. These are both from Rosie's All-American Cafe. We've got this Olaf cupcake that comes with a glow cube or a glow clip-on that you can save. And then also the Winterberry Margarita is back. This was here last year, but it was on the rocks. It's frozen now. You can also get the Winterberry Margarita at Pizza Rizzo and Backlot and ABC Commissary. Now, thus Olaf's cupcake is just vanilla cupcake, but it's got blue in the cupcake, and then it's got the buttercream with all the blue on it. So it seems like it's gonna be simple. Mm-hmm. Just a simple cupcake. It's a little heavy on the frosting for me. Look at that. That's like as much frosting as it is cupcake. Also, I really don't like it when stuff dyes my face and hands, and I have blue all over my hands already. Cute, kid friendly, and I do like those little clip-ons because then you can clip them onto your bag or something like that. And they're a little more exciting than maybe a glow cube or something because you can clip it on to different things. All right, now the margarita. So it's basically just a really cold margarita now it's not on the rocks, but it's not frozen anymore at all. It's got boba balls and then this really cute glow cube that looks like a jingle bell. Boba ball, I don't care for those. But the drink itself is really good. And it's definitely a sweeter cocktail, but it's not too sweet because the winterberry is like cranberry, so it's a little tart, and you can taste the tequila. So this is a really good pre-mixed cocktail, IMO. In honor of Olaf, I'm gonna do this one based on frozen. So a number one on a scale of 1 to 10, a 1 being when Hans tries to kill Elsa, and a 10 being when Anna punches Hans in the face. I'm gonna give the Olaf cupcake a marshmallow monster trying to kill them, which is about a 6. And I'm going to give the Winterberry Margarita a reindeer are better than people number, which is a 9. For my next treat, I have gotten the peppermint bundt shake from Hollywood Scoops. So it's a peppermint milkshake, and then it's got a little chunk of peppermint bark on there, and not one, but 2 actual cakes shoved onto the straw. Because this drink is so extra. That is such a good milkshake. This is the first like actual peppermint thing I've had besides my coffee, which I made peppermint on my own. I love peppermint, and that's a really good milkshake. Unrelated to my milkshake, it's 2 p.m. right now, and there's people lined the streets just breaking into cheers as they get their boarding groups. Really warms my soul. I didn't get a boarding group because I didn't try, because I've been on it and I'm not filming it. So I don't want to take a spot, but it's kind of fun when you can hear people celebrating because they got it. It's not bad. It's just a plain pound cake, maybe? Yeah, pound cake has been dyed certain colors. So I like its simplicity. It's already an aggressively decadent dessert. You don't need a crazy cake. On a scale of 1 to 10. 1 being when Ron is mean to Hermione at the Yule Ball, and a 10 being when Hermione walks down the stairs looking amazing. Yes, I know I'm in the wrong park to make this reference. I'm awarding this a Dumbledore dancing with Professor McGonagall. That's a 10. That's a 10. That's a sweet moment, and this is a sweet, awesome Christmas drink. I wanted to show off some of the popcorn buckets and sippers as well. They have the white Christmas tree that we saw at Magic Kingdom. They've got the alien and the plaid pajamas popcorn bucket, which was last year. And then they've got this jingle bell sipper. It's green this year. Last year, it was red. The sipper and the popcorn buckets were located at Anaheim Produce on Sunset. But you'll likely be able to find some of the popcorn buckets at the popcorn carts near the Chinese Theater as well. Quick poll, are these scary or adorable? Here we've got another holiday cocktail. This one you can get right here at the Brown Derby Lounge, or you can get it inside the Brown Derby if you choose to sit down and eat. It's called the Holiday Lights. And it's Captain Morgan Spiced Rum, Parrot Bay Coconut Rum, a little pineapple, and a splash of grenadine. And of course, you gotta get a glow cube. You know what? This doesn't taste like Christmas. Tastes like I should be at the beach, which I'm not mad about. I'm just saying, I don't know why this is a Christmas cocktail. It's a little sweet for my taste. You may know that I don't love sweet drinks, and this is very sweet. But it's a good beachy drink. It just, again, makes no sense. On a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being when Clark Griswold's father-in-law is mean to him, and a 10 is when his father is nice to him about the lights not working, I award this a Mele Kalikimaka, that song part of the movie, when he looks out and sees his pool. That's about a 6, because that's good. It's fine, but it's not holiday. Or is it? Is it like Santa Claus is at Hawaii? Is it like the day after Christmas where Santa's like vacationing? Let me know. Just walked into Pizza Rizzo to pick up my next treat. I just wanted to point out they have that Jingle Bell Supper here, as well as some of the other quick service locations. It's not just at Anaheim Produce. Next up, this is a frozen salted caramel hot chocolate. I got it at Pizza Rizzo, but you can also get it at Backlot and Rosie's, some of the other quick service locations. This is the non-alcoholic version, but they also do it with Kahlua if you want to have a little extra holiday festivities. But it comes with that cute Mickey Jingle Bell shaped glow cube as well, and some marshmallows and sprinkles, chocolate on top of all the cocoa. Okay, that's delicious. Wow. You can really taste the salted caramel aspect of it. So it cuts it down from being quite so rich as if it was just regular, like hot cocoa. I can see where with Kahlua, that would be phenomenal. I do like the milkshake more though. So if you're trying to decide between the two, for me, the peppermint milkshake won, but for a lot, if you're a hot chocolate fan, this would win. And it's nice to be able to drink hot chocolate in Florida because it's frozen. And it's fun that the kids can have this one. On a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being when Charlie graffitis the school in Santa Claus 2, which is very not cool, and a 10 being when Scott Calvin saves the auction by getting everybody toys, I would give this a Santa and the vice principal riding in the sleigh, and it's really magical and wonderful, which it's about an 8. I'm at Backlot Express now. First thing, I got this little mousse tree, which is a chai mousse on an almond cake with a butter cookie. And then I also got this hot cocoa flight that you can get a couple other places as well, but it's a cocoa with Stoli vanilla, a cocoa with Red Stag by Jim Beam, and a cocoa with Bailey's. So a little samplage there. It's hard to get. Okay, there's the mousse. I can taste both the milk chocolate and the chai. So it's good mousse. You have to like chai. And then I'm gonna try to get a bite with a little bit of everything, but I don't know if I can cut it. I wish the almond was a little more aggressive because I really like the almond flavoring, like almond extract in cookies and stuff. I think it's because my family makes spritz cookies at Christmas, so that's what reminds me of. I do like the milk chocolate chai mousse. I like it more than the chocolate mousse that was on the pine cone because it's a little bit different. It's not quite as rich, but you do have to like chai. And then the butter cookie just doesn't have a lot of flavor. It's definitely different. It's really cute. I don't know why Disney's leaning heavily into chai this Christmas season. I'm not mad about it because I like that flavor. But in this complex dessert with multiple flavors, that's definitely the strongest one. Now for a little hot cocoa. All right, we are starting with the Stoli Vanille. That is so yummy. That is so yummy. You guys know I'm more of a coffee fan, but there's just something so Christmassy about cocoa. And now the Red Stag. Oh, that's the Red Stag cherry. Yeah, you can taste that cherry. And now the Bailey's. So good. I think I like the vanilla the most, actually, though. Because I like vanilla flavored vodka, which is exactly what that is. But the Bailey's is probably going to be the most popular. You can also get any of these if you don't want to do the little flight thing. If you want to just have a full-size cup of one of the cocos with the alcohol of your choice, you can order those as well. On a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being the part of Frosty the Snowman when Frosty melts, 10 being White Christmas because that's my favorite Christmas song, I'm going to give the Moose Cake a sleigh ride, which is about a 7, 7.5. And I'm going to give the Hot Cocoa Flight a Rockin' Around the Christmas Tree, which is an 8. I'd like to bump that to an 8.5. Next up, we've got two treats from ABC Commissary, this giant sugar cookie, which I picked up. Those are my fingerprints, don't stress, that you can also get at Rosie's, but also this pumpkin pie cheesecake that you can only get here at ABC Commissary. Pumpkin pie cheesecake up first. I love both pumpkin and cheesecake, so I'm pretty excited about this one. Come on, little guy. This is not easy to get out of the little container. Okay, there we go. That is so good. Oh my gosh. These are treats, I think, 9 and 10 for the day. And this is so good. You have to like pumpkin, because it's super pumpkin-y. So it's super creamy. Now for this giant sugar cookie, doesn't look like it's gonna be any different than the ones that you can get at the bakery cases at like the confectionery or Zuri Sweet Shop in Animal Kingdom, or some of the resort gift shops. They do all the like basic treats and those all have holiday makeovers like the apples and the Rice Krispie treats, and they do the big sugar cookies. So it feels like this is just the same thing but with a different design. That said, I love those giant sugar cookies. So let's see how this one stacks up. Tastes like one of those giant sugar cookies. A little bit different though. It almost tastes like it's a butter cookie. Let me check. Confirmed, it's a butter cookie. So I'm actually loving it because it's not super sweet. And again, I've had a lot of sugar today. So I'm actually loving that it's not aggressively sweet. On a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being if you made a gingerbread house and then it fell apart, like the frosting didn't hold, and 10 being if you made the most beautiful gingerbread house, like the one over at the Grand Floridian, not this year, but in years, many years past. I'm gonna give both of these a gingerbread village, which is like a 9. For me, these are both hits. The final two treats of the day are coming from Baseline Tap House. One is this cocktail, Christmas on the Beach, that you could also have gotten at the Brown Derby. It's got coconut rum and blue curacao, and then the cranberry and pineapple juices again. And then also we've got a maple bourbon creme brulee. So let's see how these stack up as the final two of the day. This drink tastes alarmingly like the last one because it's the same juices and one of the same alcohols. It's just got blue curacao instead of spiced rum. So whatever I rated the last one, I'm gonna rate this one. It was cool because I ordered and the bartender was like, give us a second, the chef is making the creme brulee right now. He was like blazing it as I ordered it. So that's cool, it's not been sitting there. You can definitely taste the maple. Oh, and the bourbon, hello. Into this. It's obviously super sweet because it's creme brulee, but the bourbon helps balance it a little bit. And it's got unique flavors. It is really expensive though. It's like $12, which it's Disney World, but that's a lot. Most everything else I've been getting has been like 6, maybe 8. So since neither of these are really Christmas flavors, I'm gonna rank these on a Thanksgiving scale. So on a scale of 1 to 10, where 1 is cranberry sauce, like the kind from the can. Does anyone actually like that? Everyone gets it and puts it on their table, but like, does anyone actually eat it? Let me know. And a 10 is green bean casserole, because that's my favorite part of Thanksgiving. I'm going to give the drink a 6.5, which is a stuffing, because some people love stuffing. It's their favorite thing. Some people don't love stuffing. It's not their favorite thing. I don't love stuffing, and I also don't love sweet drinks. So that's where I sit on this one. And then I'm going to give
the maple bourbon creme brulee, a pumpkin pie, which is an 8 because it's a fun seasonal dessert. So not my favorite, just as pumpkin pie is not my favorite dessert at Thanksgiving, but still very good and appeals to many.
Good morning.
Jumbo from Disney's Animal Kingdom, where I'm about to pick up one of the holiday snacks. And by one of, I mean the only one that is out right now. Animal Kingdom has 4 different holiday snacks that are coming, but most of them are not going to be available until December hits. So what they do have right now is a pumpkin ice cream sandwich at Dino Bites, which I'm literally giddy about because I adore ice cream sandwiches and I adore pumpkin. And I'm glad we're getting a little more pumpkin in the season and we're not straight going to peppermint. But speaking of peppermint, Satouli Canteen is getting a peppermint mousse towards the end of December. They are doing a gingerbread creature cupcake at some of the places around the park, as well as a Santa Dome brownie. So those are a few things that are coming in December, but for now, pumpkin cookie ice cream sandwich. Dino Bite Snacks is right here in Dinoland next to Restaurantosaurus, and they're known for these ice cream sandwiches where they get 2 cookies and put hand scooped ice cream in the middle. They've done seasonal ones in the past. Last year they did a peppermint one, but this year I'm again delighted that they're doing pumpkin. It's right here on the menu. It's 2 pumpkin cookies, vanilla ice cream, and then fall sprinkles. Yum, yum, yum. Okay, this baby is pumpkin spice cookies, hand scooped vanilla ice cream. I'm literally giddy about it. It's also not 1 million degrees today, so the ice cream hasn't completely melted everywhere. It's almost a cool day, and by that I mean it's like 75. It feels great. I cannot wait to eat this. It's not a graceful way to do this, so. Kudos to the bakery team, because they always make the perfect cookies for these that are like soft enough for you to bite into easily, but firm enough to hold up to all the ice cream. This is so good. I'm so glad we're getting another pumpkin treat because I really thought it was gonna be all gingerbread and all peppermint from here on out. And despite my ensemble, I'm team pumpkin. It's my favorite seasonal flavor. And this is so good. You have to like pumpkin because the cookies are very pumpkin-y. It's almost like eating a pumpkin spice latte cookie sandwich. But this may be my favorite one I've ever had. I always liked the, they had a strawberry shortcake one last year during the summer that was like strawberry ice cream rolled in strawberry shortcake. That one was really good, but this one may be my favorite. But I love pumpkin. If you don't like pumpkin, get the classic one here that's just like chocolate chip cookies. But wow, that is amazing. Well done. Kudos, Dino Bites. Mwah. This is one of my favorite snacks all the time. Even better when it's pumpkin. On a scale of 1 to 10, where 1 is Jack's Lament, because that song is boring, and a 10 is What's This, because it's all about Christmas, I give this an Oogie Boogie song, which is about Halloween taking over Christmas, which is literally what this sandwich represents. And that's a 10, because that's my favorite part of that movie. Possibly the most special piece of decor in Animal Kingdom, though, are these snowflakes. These were made by men and women from the Augusta Training Shop, which is a nonprofit organization in Augusta, Georgia. And it employs men and women with cognitive and physical disabilities to make different things and use their hands and teaches them a new skill. And so they made these gorgeous snowflakes, and I love that. I thought I wouldn't find any more holiday treats here at Animal Kingdom, but as I was looking at mobile order at the Flame Tree Barbecue, they have a holiday exclusive beverage, but there's something familiar about it. This is the same drink they had for Halloween. If you watch that video, you'll recognize it, but now there's a Christmas glow cube because of course there is. It's 2020. All right, so this cocktail is actually made out of Angry Orchard apple cider and Fireball. So cheers. Yeah, tastes the exact same it did just a few months ago, but now it's got merriment and holiday cheer. And I guess technically apples work for both holidays. So yeah, it is a really good beverage if you like apple cider. It kind of tastes like boozy apple juice, just a hint of that Fireball. But yeah, this is hilarious to me that Disney just was like, just throw a holiday glow cube in there. It's Christmas now. For the record, the non-alcoholic version does not come with the glow cube. And I asked if you could buy it separately, and they said no, because think, because it's all on mobile order. Sometimes you can buy just the glow cube, but for now, when I'm filming this, you can only get the very cute Mickey Jingle Bell glow cube if you order the alcoholic version. But they're going to have this glow cube. We've already seen it some other place on property. So this is like a standard issue glow cube that you'll see around Walt Disney World during the holidays. You don't have to just get it here. On a scale of 1 to 10, where a 1 is when Lucy pulls the football away from Charlie Brown, and a 10 is when they all gather around the Christmas tree and sing "Oh Christmas Tree" around that pathetic tree, I award this a Schroeder on the piano, because that's about a 7. It's a pretty good pre-made cocktail for a Disney cocktail. I'm into it because I like both apple juice and Fireball, so cheers. Now, you may have lost track of which holiday snacks are the best, and I don't blame you. There are so many to choose from. So I made a list of my 10 favorite holiday snacks in Walt Disney World this year. To get the list, all you need to do is head over to AllEars.net/10holiday snacks. That link is in the bio for you. Sign up for our free newsletter, and that list is coming straight to your inbox. Happy eating, or should I say, merry eating. Well, friends, that is a wrap on my holiday treats around Walt Disney World video. I had almost 30 different treats across 3 parks, and I hope you found a new holiday treat that you want to try if you're coming to Walt Disney World this holiday season. Some favorites for me included that peppermint milkshake from Hollywood Scoops, that giant cookie from ABC Commissary, that little tree from Gaston's Tavern at Magic Kingdom, and that pumpkin ice cream sandwich over at Animal Kingdom. We've got more holiday merriment coming your way. We've got one all about what you can do at Magic Kingdom right now with the cavalcades and a few holiday surprises from me. I'm going to do a Festival of the Holidays video, and that starts at Epcot later this month, so stay tuned for all of that merriment. In the meantime, friends, let me know which treat you'd like to try the most. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments, and make sure to follow us on Instagram, rate, review, subscribe to our channel. Look forward to seeing you again. It's been so magical. I'm Molly, and it's been merry. Want to see more of my videos? Click over here. Want to subscribe? You can do that right here. And also, ring that notification bell to make sure you get instantly notified anytime we post a new video. Thanks for following. See you real soon.